Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss some of the prototype methods. So this video is going to show you a number of methods. First, I'm going to discuss the setPrototypeOf and the getPrototypeOf methods. And then I'm going to discuss the keys, values, and entries methods. And then the other one is to discuss is the getOwnPropertyNames method. Finally, I'm going to discuss the hasOwnProperty method. So they are quite helpful to understand the inheritance relationship of objects. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is pretty simple. I just have a title and a heading. And the HTML file is going to link to a JavaScript file. The file name is called myscript.js. This JavaScript file is stored in a JS folder. And for the JavaScript code, I want to use the strict mode. That's why I have to say use strict on the first line of the JavaScript file. And then I'm going to discuss the prototype methods. So other than using the dunderproto approach, we can use other methods to create objects and set the prototype relationship. So I'm going to show you the ways now. Suppose I have two objects. One is called student and the other is called teacher. If I want to create an object that is linked to an object to demonstrate the inheritance relationship, other than using the dunderproto approach, I can do something like this. Now, I have set up an object called Alice, and the Alice is actually inheriting some properties from the student object shown here. And in addition to using the student object, I want to add some new key value pairs to the Alice object. So the new key value pair is just year whose value is 2016. So you can expect that Alice studies geography and the current year of study is just 2016. So in this way, by using the object.create method, I'm able to create an object and set the prototype with the new property value pairs added, which is this one, which is the year and 2016 being the property value pair being added. And then I can see whether the linkage is successful or not. So let me see, save, reload. Yes, you can see that Alice studies geography and the current year of study for Alice is 2016. So Alice is just based on the student object. So you can say that Alice is a student. That's why we can set the prototype of Alice to student. Okay. And then I'm going to change the prototype relationship between Alice and another object. Suppose Alice is now not a student, but she becomes a teacher. If I want to change the prototype relationship, how can I do this? Let me show you my way. Now I just use object.setPrototypeOf method to set the prototype of Alice to be teacher rather than using student initially. So we can check the properties again. Okay, you can see that Alice has a name, which should refer to the name of the teacher. And Alice has got some years of experience, which comes from the teacher object. So let me see if it is really the case of or not after doing the setPrototypeOf method. Save, reload. Yes, Cindy becomes the name. And Alice has 5 years of experience. So all these values come from the teacher object. So we can see that the inheritance relationship has changed. Alice is a teacher rather than a student right now. So we can see the power of the setPrototypeOf method, okay? We can also do the checking more explicitly by doing another alert window like this one. Now I can use the getPrototypeOf method to see the relationship more clearly. Okay, now I can do the alert window to see whether the prototype of this is really referring to the teacher object. So I should get true. Save. Reload. Yes, I get true. So the getPrototypeOf method is able to help us check the prototype more easily. And now I'm going to discuss more prototype methods. The first one is about the keys of an object. So suppose I want to see the keys coming from Alice. I just use object.keys method and the parameter is replaced by alice.thunderproto. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that the keys of Alice have come out. Alice has the name as well as the years of experience. So because the thunderproto property is linked to the teacher object, you can expect that Alice just takes the key value pairs from the prototype called teacher. So that's why we can see the keys coming from the teacher object. Let me show you another prototype method, which is also quite useful. Rather than showing the keys, I can also show the values of an object. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that Alice has two values, which are Cindy and 5. Cindy refers to the name, and 5 refers to the years of experience. So rather than showing the keys, I can also show the values directly. And of course, the values come from the prototype of Alice, which refers to the teacher object. Another method to discuss is the entries method. So what will I get? Let me see. Save. Reload. Yes, I can see that the key value pairs would come out together. So the name is Cindy and the years of experience is 5. So by using the object.entries method, I can get both the keys and values of an object that represents the prototype of the Alice object. So Alice is linked to the teacher object. That's why you can see the teacher content is shown up here. Another prototype method to discuss is the one that shows all the string keys to us. How can we use it? Let me show you now. I use the getOwnPropertyNames method coming from the object class. So what will I get? Let's see. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that Alice has two own property names. One is called the name and the other is called years of experience. Of course, they both inherit from the prototype of Alice, which is the teacher object. Okay. So these two properties are the Alice's own properties. If I want to show whether an object has its own property or not, I can have another prototype method to use. Let me show you now. Now I'm going to see whether Alice has its own property called year. So let me save it and reload the page. You can see the answer is true. And the reason is that Alice has been added a key value pair about the year. So you can see here, Alice has a key value pair about the year coming from the creation here. That's why you can see that Alice has its own property. And this is the own property of Alice. So even though Alice is now linked to another object. The key value pair about the year will still remain in the Alice object. That's why we will see true. So it means that the teacher object is going to link to Alice, and you can expect that Alice would have properties coming from the teacher. But for this own property, Alice still has this key value pair. That's why we will see true here, because the year property really belongs to Alice, but not to the teacher object. Now I'm going to see the situation if I want to check for an inherited property. Now I want to see whether Alice has its own property called name. As we can see, the name property comes from the teacher but not from the Alice object itself. That's why you can expect that the name property is an inherited one rather than belonging to the object itself. So let me see. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that I will get false because the name property comes from the inheritance relationship between the object called Alice and the teacher. So name is not. So name is just inherited to Alice, but it is not a particular property that Alice has explicitly. That's why you can see false here. So we can see that in this video, we have already discussed a lot of things about the prototype methods. What methods have we discussed? We have set up the connection between two objects by using the Object.create method. We are also able to set a prototype by using the setPrototypeOf method. We can get a prototype by using the getPrototypeOf method. And we have also learned the keys, values and entries methods to understand the key value pairs coming from the prototype of an object. And we are able to see the key value pairs altogether. And we are able to get the string keys by using the getOwnPropertyNames method. We can also see that whether a certain key belongs to the object itself or belongs to the inheriting object rather than the object itself. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.